lagi.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Hi everyone. I would like to say thank you for coming to our presentation. It's great to see you all. The Honorable Lecturer Mr. Subadar and all of my beloved friends. First of all, let us thanks to the Almighty Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Because of his blessing, we are able to come here to join in this English meeting. Please share screen. Okay, let me introduce myself and my team. I am Lulu Asriani, and my team is Mrs. Tuti Aisyah, Mrs. Herawati, Mrs. Yeni Trisilangningsi, Mrs. Asmarani, Mrs. Anissa Putriasari, and me, Lulu Asriani. Ladies and gentlemen, the presentation today is about simple present tense. Now, I will read one by one our agenda today. That are, the first session is opening, the second session is introduction, the third session is presentation time for our team, the fourth session is opinion question and answer session, the fifth session is closing. Well, ladies and gentlemen, let's open our meeting by saying basmalah together.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Thank you. For the next agenda is presentation session. For the first turn, will be given by the first presenter. Please, Mrs. Tuti Aisyah, for slide 4 and 5.
Okay. Simple present tense. The simple present tense is used to talk about something general, something that always happens over and over, or a general thought. The simple present tense is the tense that is most often used in everyday life to recognize that a sentence is a simple present tense. There are several ways that can be done, one of which is using the basic form of the verb one. Next. Simple present tense is divided into two sentences. Patterns, namely, one, verbal sentence, two, non-verbal sentence. Thank you, Miss Lulu.
Thank you, Bunda. Next turn is for the second presenter, Mrs. Herawati, for slide 6 and 7.
Verbal sentences are sentences that have a finite verb as a predicate. Next. Positive sentence, formula, subject, plus verb one by adding S or ES or IES, plus object, plus complement. The S or ES ending in verb is only used in the subject, he, she, and it. Example, verb one, go, she goes, he goes, it goes. I go, you go, they go, we go. Thank you, Miss Lulu.
You're welcome, Bunda. Next turn is for the third presenter, yaitu Mrs. Yeni, for slide 8 and 9.
Okay. Dalam menambahkan akhiran S, IS, terdapat aturannya. Kata yang menggunakan akhiran S dan S, IS adalah 1. Kata kerja berakhiran huruf Y dan huruf sebelum Y adalah huruf vokal. Maka kata kerja ditambahkan S. Says. Says example sentence. Sonia says everything is going to be alright. Buys. Buys. Maaf. Buy. Buys. Example sentence. Daddy buys new car. Try. Price. Example sentence. He prays 5 times a day. Kata kerja berakhiran huruf Y dan huruf sebelum Y adalah huruf konsonan. Maka kata kerja ditambahkan ES dan menghilangkan huruf Y-nya. Contoh, studies. Example sentence. Budi studies so hard for national examination. Carries. Example sentence. Mom carries the baby with stroller. Next. Three. Kata kerja yang berakhiran huruf O, CH, SH, X, dan Z, maka ditambahkan ES pada akhir kata kerja. Contohnya, goes. Example sentence. He goes to the market every day. Watches. Example sentence. We watches TV after walking. Washes. Example sentence. My mom washes the dishes every night. Thank you, Miss Lulu.
You're welcome, Bunda. Next turn is for the fourth presenter, Mrs. Asmarani, for slide 10 and 11.
Okay. B, negative sentence. To form negative, usually use the addition do not or does not before the verb. The formula subject plus do or does plus not plus verb 1 plus object plus complement. Example sentences. Budi does not go to Bali every Monday. They do not go to school every day. Interrogative sentence. Untuk membentuk kalimat interrogatif atau kalimat pertanyaan, biasanya menggunakan tambahan do atau does di depan kalimat. The formula do or does plus subject plus object plus complement question mark. Example sentences. Number one, does Budi go to Bali every Monday? Yes, he does or no, he does not. Number two, do children go to school every day? Yes, they do or no, they do not. Number three, do they watch a new movie every day? Yes, they do or no, they do not.
Thank you. Next turn is for the fifth presenter, Mrs. Anissa, for slide 12 and 13.
Okay, not verbal sentence. Not verbal sentence is a sentence whose predicate is not a finite verb. The predicate of a non-verbal sentence can be an adjective, a noun, an adverb, or other type of word. In this use, it requests auxiliary word in the form of an auxiliary verb or to be. Is, I'm, are. I am, she is, he is, it is, you are, we are, they are. Next. Okay. A, positive sentence. The formula S plus to be plus noun or adjective or adverb plus object plus complement. Example sentence. You are a student at a language school. Rika is the beautiful girl in her village. And last, I am a dancer. Thank you, Miss Lulu.
You're welcome. Next turn is for the sixth presenter by myself. B, negative sentence. The formula is subject plus to be plus not plus noun or adjective or adverb plus object plus complement. Example sentence, I'm not a student. The umbrella is not under the table. There are no teachers at my school. Next. C, interrogative sentence. The formula is to be plus subject plus object plus complement question mark. Example sentence, are these students in a language school? Yes, they are. No, they are not. Is the umbrella under the table? Yes, it is. No, it is not. Is Tala a dancer? Yes, he is. No, she is not. Thank you for all presenters. Well, ladies and gentlemen, now we are come to the opinions, question and answer. Anybody would like to ask? Maybe 3 questions is enough for us now. Silakan yang mau bertanya.
Ya. Baik. Aku mau bertanya ini. Masih ada yang belum paham mengenai waktu apa saja? Mengenai waktu apa saja yang digunakan dalam simple present tense? Beserta contohnya seperti apa itu? Terima kasih.
Oke, aku coba jawab ya. Jadi keterangan waktu yang digunakan dalam simple present tense itu banyak ya Bunda. Ada every day, every night, always, usually, sometimes, once a week, once a day, 3 times a month, 3 times a year, seperti itu. Adapun contohnya, Susie goes to school every day. It usually rains every day here. Jelas ya Bunda ya?
Ya,
silakan yang lain yang mau bertanya.
Aku dulu.
Ya, silakan.
Oke. Mau tanya tentang jenis bentuk simple present tense yang menggunakan verbal form itu apa aja ya?
Baik, Bunda, saya ingin mencoba menjawab. Ya, verbal form itu ada 3 macam. 1 positive form, 2 negative form, dan 3 integrative form. Sudah itu aja, Bun.
Makasih, Bu.
Bagaimana, Bunda? Ya, sama-sama, Bunda.
Ya, silakan. Ada lagi yang mau bertanya?
Sebutkan bentuk atau pola kalimat simple present tense. Terima kasih.
Ya, silakan teman-teman. Siapa yang mau menjawab?
Saya coba untuk menjawab ya, Bun.
Ya, silakan.
Ya, bentuk atau pola kalimat simple present tense itu terbagi menjadi 2, yaitu yang pertama verbal simple present tense dan yang kedua nominal simple present tense. Seperti itu Bunda Hera, sudah cukup jelas?
Terima kasih Bu Rani.
Sama-sama Bunda.
Jelas ya semuanya? Oke, well ladies and gentlemen, finally, we are came to the last agenda. We would like to say thanks again for the presenter and all of the audience for active participation. The conclusion of presentation today is 1. Simple present tense are tenses that are used to express conditions that we usually do in daily activities. To recognize that a sentence is a simple present tense, there are several ways that can be done, one of which is using the basic form of the verb 1. 2, simple present tense is divided into 2 sentence patterns. E, verbal sentence. B, non-verbal sentence or nominal sentence. 3, verbal sentence and non-verbal sentence consists of positive sentence, negative sentence, and interrogative sentence. That's the conclusion. Hopefully, the presentation will give benefit for us. Thank you for your attention. See you later. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, sir.